candidate of the ACPN. And our businesses in Nigeria complain generally about multiple taxation. What are you going to do differently? How are you going to reduce the burden of multiple taxation for businesses?
Yes, multiple taxation is not good for the growth of businesses. And business owners are usually not happy about it. I'm a businessman too. If you are forbidding me too much, I may be weakened and the business may eventually collapse. We have such a situation in one of the states in this country that industry are packing away to other places due to multiple taxation and tax burdens. What we do is to encourage business people by making sure that we structure the type of taxes in order to that we impose on them in order to reduce tax burden. And in most cases, to encourage some, especially new businesses that will be coming to the country, to grant tax tariff until the businesses get properly footed. And when you are talking about taxation, you're also talking about economy. We do everything by encouraging the private sector to drive the economy. And we embrace reform. Because if there's no business, there's nowhere the government will generate. Nobody will pay taxation. If you are not doing anything, you can't pay tax. This is a sort of this that a party, the Allied Congress Party of Nigeria, is coming on board in this campaign, which we know the crucial issue that will be on the burner is the issue of economy and security. We are bringing on board an international economic advisor in the name of Dr. Obi Ezekwesili. He's an expert in economy. He's an expert, and we believe that the issue of economic problems of this country will be analyzed, and she will take Nigeria path to the path of progress and prosperity.
Thank you very much. Any reporters on any issue, candidate of the APC?
Just a quick rebuttal, and that is that we already have pioneer status. For new businesses, you already have a five-year tax holiday, some between 3 and 5 years. There's also, just to point out to my fellow candidate, that there is also a tax threshold for small businesses. You know, beyond that threshold is when you begin to pay taxes. So some of these tax holidays are already in place, you know, and perhaps they may have other ideas, but these are already in place.
Candidate of the ANN.
Yes, I have. He said they are already in place, but they are not implemented. Because I'm a business person, and I know how much tax that is being demanded from our little company. I'm believing that once you are a small business, you need some kind of relief for the next 1 to 3 years, 1 to 5 years, to ensure that you are able to garner some profit from what businesses that you're doing. But every time, all businesses are strangulated because of the tax. The local government area will ask for tax. All kinds of regulatory bodies will come and ask for the state government. The state, if you're like, we are operating a bakery in Mina, every time they keep telling us, you have to pay for this board, you have to pay for that. And different kinds of people, because of the corruption, it has affected so many businesses that businesses cannot thrive because of
Thank
all
you
this.
Very much.
So we
Thank
need
you.
Implementation.
Thank you. Well, let me start from here this time, and let me start with the candidate of the PDP. The African Continental Free Trade Area Agreement. Nigeria was instrumental in putting that in place, but Nigeria is yet to sign. Would you say that Nigeria should sign and belong to the Continental Economic Bloc? What advantages do you think Nigeria stands to reap from that?
The Nigeria needs to look at that agreement properly, because actually, if you had built your economy as strong as it should be, we will benefit more. We are the biggest market. Yes, you think about people bringing in their goods here, But considering that the resources of the human resources of this country and the entrepreneurial spirit of the average Nigerian, we would have been able to build facilities, manufacturing facilities that would drive export, not just within Africa. African trade today is less than 9%. And if we get it right, it can go as high as 30% or 40%. A foreign exchange, you're saying today you're not earning from oil. Oil line gives you 80% of your foreign exchange. When in effect, if you do the right things, you can have twice that coming from manufacturing. Other countries that don't have anything to do with oil are driving their foreign exchange earning all from manufacturing. So you have to look at the agreement, look at those things we're not doing well here, put them in place, and sign that agreement, because it's going to be a win-win for us. It's just that the manufacturer said, let's look at this. Let's know what is there for us. There's no way you can be part of packaging something and it gets to the stage of signing, you walk out of it. So what were you doing when you were part of packaging, putting it together? It doesn't make sense.
Thank you very much. Candidate of the APC.
Frankly, I thought my colleague of the PDP would say whether to sign or not to sign, you know. But let me just say very quickly that there is a process of consultation which is going on with the private sector. That process is very important because one of the chief fears of the continental free trade zone, one of the chief fears of it is the possibility of transshipment. Third countries will transship. So, for example, a China can ship its goods to Benin Republic and import to Nigeria under a free trade agreement. So we can have a situation where local industry is killed just by the mere fact that we sign on to this without ensuring that all of the loopholes have been blocked. So we're in the process of ensuring that those loopholes are blocked. The Manufacturers Association of Nigeria, MAN, rejected the Continental Free Trade Zone here, and we're talking to them. Similarly, in ASIMA, several of the business bodies, even Industrial and Competitiveness Council, have expressed serious reservations, and we must consult. We are a private sector-driven economy. We cannot just say because we were involved in the process. Every African country was involved in the process. But it's our duty as a responsible government to ensure that we take into account all of the different issues that are involved before we sign. Even trade remedies, even a regime of trade remedies, we have not put in place, the AFCTA has not put in place a sufficient regime of trade remedies. All of these issues have to be taken into account. There's no hurry to rush into signing that agreement. There's no hurry whatsoever. We must make sure that we cover all our bases, all the bases, before we sign. That really is the issue.
Thank you very much. Candidate of the ANN.
So if we're going to, we have to look at all the surrounding circumstances of the agreement before signing. We have the policy to be driven by private sector, like you said, but we, in our own way, we're looking at it in a different way, because once you sign an agreement, you are already completely bounded by it. We have to look at how much that agreement will affect the common man in the street. How much employment will that agreement bring? How will it upgrade the development of our industries, which we're looking at diversifying? How will it also affect the GDP that we're looking to expand? So in that agreement, we'll sit down and ensure that there is provision for employment, where issues of employment, because a lot of times we see that the Chinese government are coming in, and they are coming in with all their people, to most of their people, to come and work, without taking cognizance that we have a lot of people who are unemployed in Nigeria. So what we will do as a party in our government is to ensure that everybody is taken care of, because we also want to collaborate with other parties, other countries. We want to encourage free trade zone. We'll also look at how much that agreement will affect our local industries. If it's going to help us, if it's going to be like an exchange, it's important for us to look at it carefully before signing. And it has to be in alliance, it has to be in tandem with what our general policies stand for in our government.
Thank you very much.